Hi everybody, it's TJ with PTU Trend Jumper and Premier Trader University. We've got a lot of new Trend Jumper members. I wanted to do a walkthrough video with some of our Forex swing trades. I'll be using mostly TradeStation charts because it's easier to maneuver around, but I will pull up some MT4 charts as well. We'll look at some of those. I'll just talk through the setups a little bit for the MT4 users. But what I show you on Trend Jumper works the same as MT4 for the most part, other than a new post I put up alerting everyone about the little Sunday bars that show up on the MT4 charts. And those are not part of the trade plan. We'll take a look at a few of them. I'll point them out to you. You would be best avoiding them at this point. I do not have Sunday bars on TradeStation, but they are showing up on the MT4 charts. So beware of those. You want to avoid them because they're usually very small and they're prone to triggering in and stopping out maybe more than once in the same session because of how small they are. But also they're easy to spot because they're so small. So I'll show you those. I want to start with the Euro US. This has been a pretty amazing market over the last several months, and I actually want to go back and set the stage a little. The last half of 2011, you see we're in 2011 here, the trades were just simply amazing on the Euro US. In fact, we were day trading with a 5-minute chart and were able to rack up well over 2,000 pips by the end of the year. And with a really strong 70%+ winning percentage, we were getting 100 pip days day trading the Euro US. Okay, and that was leading up to the end of 2011. When 2012 started, everything changed. For whatever reason, the range got tighter, the trades got smaller, the day trades were pretty much a waste of time, where we were getting 30 and 40 pip moves, a 20 pip trade was on the smaller end. Now we're lucky if the day trades on the 5-minute chart are more than 15 pips or 10 pips. And the swing trading wasn't so good either. In fact, this was the worst performing pair for the first two-thirds of the year with Trend Jumper, while all the other pairs were raking it in, and you could see from the results that we showed you several times, the many thousands of pips profit, the Euro US was actually underwater. Every now and then you'd pick up a nice trade like this, but there were a lot of losses. But ultimately, it hit its rock bottom, and right around this time of year, late summer, early fall, it started to come alive again. And I'll never forget when I presented this chart here leading into the Trend Jumper launch, the first one. And this sequence of trades here completely turned around the year for the Euro US, which actually ended up well over 1,000 pips positive for 2012. But if that was the only pair you were trading for the first part of the year and you were just starting Trend Jumper, you would have been in trouble. In fact, you probably would have quit and you would have thrown away an extremely powerful and profitable strategy. And then, so what's happened since? Well, the Euro US has been spectacular. It's continued to be consistent. There's a few losses every now and then. That's always going to happen no matter what. And that's okay. You have to expect it. Remember, we've got that really great risk-reward ratio and the way to hit big trades and build a nice position as we did here leading into the beginning of this year. The beginning of this year was a lot different than the beginning of 2012 for the Euro US. I'm still not interested in the day trades, but the swing trades, they have been powerful. And so that brings us up to where we're at now. We're almost halfway through 2013, and it's been nothing but winners on the Euro US going up and coming down. Now, you hopefully have seen the trade plan on the Owners Club. I handle the add-on trades in a very special way. I call them rolling add-on trades. And what I mean by that is if a prior trade cancels or stops out or completes in some way, shape, or form, then the next add-on trade is not going to be, it's not going to progress to the next number. It's going to stay put. In other words, if it would have been add-on number 2, but then an earlier trade finishes, it will then be add-on 1 again. Okay, and it's important to understand that distinction. So let me show you what I mean. Here's a short, right? This happened beginning of February, February 13th actually. Pretty straightforward jump trade, very clear. Comes down, hits the first target on the primary trade at the first target. I trail the jump line, but at this point, the jump line came down to here, and I'm able to cut my risk a little bit after the bar closes, couple pips above, work around the next five or zero, add a fractional pip on top of that. That's how I've been doing it. Cut risk a little bit. Then the next bar, you continue to trail that jump line down. You're not ready to completely eliminate risk because it hasn't hit the middle target yet, okay? Finally, it comes down and hits the middle target on the same bar that I have an add-on trade setting up. So I'm gonna now cut risk or trail the jump line, whichever gives me the tighter, more profitable position. In other words, whatever moves that stop closer to where the market is, right? I'm also gonna get into my first add-on trade. This is add-on number one, okay? And that one came on the 20th of February. So now I'm gonna manage add-on one differently from the primary trade, and this is all described in the Owner's Club with the trade plan. It's all written out in black and white for everyone to see. All right, hopefully you're familiar with this Forex Daily End of Day Swing Trade Plan. If you haven't found it, I suggest you look for it. It's there for you in a PDF. You can download it. Okay, it talks about spike moves. It talks about various ways to manage that trade. Then it talks about add-ons. And if you go down a little bit, you see this whole notion of the rolling add-ons. Okay? And then there's add-on number one. And then add-on number two. Add-on number one is going to be your second live position. So if you are in two live positions already, but then the primary position closes, that next add-on, which would have been add-on two, is now add on one because you're adding on one to the other add-on that's still going, and you only have two live positions. Okay? You have to have two live positions before you go to add on two, and then that would be your third live position. Your primary trade, your add on one, your add on two. As each earlier trade drops off, these go and revert one level up. Okay, so it depends on how many live positions you have. Add-on three is when you're putting on a fourth position. You've got three positions going. The primary, add-on one, and add-on two. You go to add-on three, and I only trade this with a single position to the third target. And I might even go to the second or first target if it's a really big trade and I have too much risk or based on market conditions. You know, there's a lot of flexibility here, but by and large, the results I'm tracking is based on what's printed here. Okay. The other thing I want to say is what's not really elaborated upon in this trade plan is the ability to scale out at different target levels. I really like that form of trading if you are following the risk guidelines. If you're putting on 2% risk and you can take off a quarter of your position at each target level and then let the final quarter trail per the add-on trailer, because each add-on you treat it a little differently. I think that's a good way to go because even that first target, you're practically at 1-to-1 with the risk reward ratio, and you start taking some profits on trades that end up faltering and not making it to the second or third target, and that's going to help you. It's going to help keep your account bolstered and cut costs and all that. Okay? Even if you lose on all, four of those, if you're going with four positions and all three targets in a trailer, you're still losing with that excellent risk reward ratio. So over time, it's going to pay off for you no matter what. And you would know that if you were putting those trades into the UTA spreadsheet and tracking each target instead of the setup type as a jump trade or a trailer or a crossover trade, you track them as target one, target two, target three, and trailer, and you'll be able to get statistics on each one of those positions. And that's a really great type of back test to conduct with this style of trading. That's another video. What I want to point out to you in this regard is that we're talking about add-on one, and at the first target, we use the confirmation line, the jump line four, to guide our stop. But once we hit the third target, then we revert back to the jump line nine to give that trade a chance to really capture a bigger move. Okay? Add-on two, you use the confirmation line, but then you stay with it. So it's a more aggressive stop. So it's important to understand this. But once one of those trades drops off and add-on two all of a sudden became add-on one, look at your chart and decide, what do you want to do? Do you want to revert to this money management plan or stay with the original one? I've been reverting. I've been following this rolling add-on strategy. Okay. So here's add-on one. And that one triggers in and it comes down, hits that first target. Meanwhile, the primary trade exits for 184 pips, but it's still trailing its second position. It did not stop out here because the stop was up here. This bar closed after this spike. Then the stop moved down. You see? Meanwhile, the second position, the add-on trade, it could take profit at the first target. It could take profit at the second target. And now the stop is going to follow the confirmation line here because it hasn't hit the third target yet. Then it comes all the way down to here, and the stop could press down lower to here. Meanwhile, the primary position, that stop keeps moving down as well to there. Okay, let's make the add-on one. We'll just make that yellow. Tell the difference. Okay, the stop doesn't move for the add-on position. In the meantime, I also had add-on number two. That's what this becomes. So we've got the primary position here. We've got add-on one here. We've got add-on two here. That's the third live position. And you have to know how to manage the position according to that trade plan. Okay? The stop on the primary position continues to move down to here now. Right? Just following the jump line. What about here? Does this come up and stop out add-on number one? Well, keep in mind that this stop didn't move down until it came down and almost touched the target here. You see, remember, it's based on the last bar to close below. Let's blow this up a little so we can look at it more carefully. Okay? Lots of lines in there, but remember, the add-on one position is still trailing the confirmation line, and then it stabbed down. Then it came up, this bar closed, and then the stop moved down from up here down to here. See? Now, I was watching this trade at the time. It got down to 2965. The full target is 2945. It missed by 20 pips on a very large trade. 3268 down to 2945. I had 300 pips of profit here. When I saw this and I was getting ready to enter my session for day trading, I literally marketed out of my fixed target position. I'm not going to sit here and fight over a very fractional amount of pips on a major move where I've got most of my move in hand. I'm not going to risk it coming all the way back up. If I see it, if I'm here noticing it, I'm taking that profit. I've already been able to take profit at each of these levels, and I'm still trailing my confirmation line. So when this bar closes here, I've got one quarter of my position remaining. It comes up, and it's going to hit the stop. Because the confirmation line, let's see, maybe it didn't. It's at 30633. So remember, I'm going to push that up to 3066. And then I'm going to add on top of that. I'm going to go around the next 5 or 0. So I'll go up to 3071. Add a little spread. 3073. Add a fractional. So I'm at 30736. Okay, this got up to 30746. So it stopped me out by one pip, unfortunately. Wouldn't have mattered really, because I would have only been able to move my stop a little further. It would have ended up stopping out anyway. The point is, no matter what you do with your stop here, all of a sudden, this is no longer add-on one. And this, I'm sorry, this was add-on two, not add-on three. That was add-on two. Okay, so this is add-on two, not add-on three. But now, guess what? The primary position is still trailing the jump line. It's all the way down to here. Let's get rid of the stop on the add-on one trade. Add-on two trade did trigger in, but now add-on two has become add-on one because it's only the second live position, and this is still the primary position back here. Just moving forward, the primary position, the stop ends up moving down to here. After this bar closes, it moves down to here. This add-on trade is so large, we're not anywhere near the first target, so let's just get this stop out of the way. And instead, we did have this one. This could have been an add-on trade, but it never triggered in, and it ended up canceling, closing above the EMA, the 200 EMA. Remember, if it closes above the jump line it's jumping off of, it cancels, and this was jumping off of the 200 EMA, right? The pink trade. So this trade ends up canceling. This one is live. This could become the new add-on two if it triggers in, and it does here. But what happens? The primary trade that trailed all the way down to here, that stop didn't move. Once it got to here, it didn't move, and it came up and stopped out right there, even with all the adjusting. So guess what? All of a sudden, the primary trade's finished with a really big profit. This first add-on trade, that had a nice partial profit, almost a full target. If you didn't exit that, you would have exited the whole position at the stop. Either way, it finished. But now this add-on, what used to be add-on 2, became add-on 1. Guess what? That's now your primary trade. So now this is your primary trade, and this new add-on becomes add-on 1. And so you follow the guidelines. This is what I mean by rolling add-ons. Okay? If you don't know how to manage this right, you're probably going to not get the same results. So add-on one, stop is yellow. Primary trade, stop is orange. Has not moved yet. Okay, now we have two trades that are just kind of in no man's land. They haven't hit any money management levels. Okay, days pass. This has been going on since the 25th of February. Today is the 27th of March. Okay, look what happens here. 2 days ago, there was add-on two, a new add-on two. Because these two trades are still live, and it just triggered in today. But what happened? Both the primary trade and add-on one just hit their money management levels right there, see? So now you got to go to the primary. That one's going to trail the jump line. So you get your stop in place following that jump line, right about there, give or take. When this bar closes, it's going to come down even further, right? Well, what about add-on one? Add-on one is going to trail the faster line, which isn't that much lower, but it's a little more profit, okay? And you follow the confirmation line for the second add-on trade. If they both happen to hit their third target, or if add-on one hits the third target all the way down to here, you will revert to the jump line nine as your trailer with that position as per the trade plan. But add-on two will have hit its money management level, and that one will trail the confirmation line as per the trade plan. You see? Hopefully I've explained this clearly. Hopefully if I've explained this in a way that you understand. And I was going to look at a bunch of other Forex pairs, but this video is already long. So I'm going to end this video now, and I will do another video in the near future with some of the current trades. Now that you've seen this walkthrough on the Euro US. A couple things I want you to think about. If you're new to Trend Jumper, take your time. Realize that a losing trade could happen at any time, but it's only one trade. What makes this work is just continuing with it, low risk, trade a number of pairs, be consistent each day, but especially go through the success guide and do your foundation building. If you are not backtesting these trades and this trade plan, thinking it through, building a log of trades, building your belief structure, building your confidence, then at the first sign of a losing trade that you might have not even done correctly in the first place, or you put on too much risk, or all those things that traders, you know, the mistakes traders make, then it's just going to be your own fault. The strategy is working amazingly well. It's made many thousands of pips in not in a long period of time, and it's continuing to rake them in. On the next video, I'll show you some of the trades I'm currently in, and I'll show you exactly that what I'm saying is true, because these trades are already extremely profitable, and well, hopefully some of you are in some of these. So I'll take a look at those at the next video. Thanks for joining me in this one. Hope you learned something. See you next time. This is TJ with PTU Trend Jumper and Premier Trader University.